Nation of Islam. We took people in my car. We took a carload of people over to the San Francisco, to the temple, every week, every weekend, on Sundays. Now, we didn't think it was any big deal, but the government looked at it like this. If those ideas, number one, who is this guy? Well, everybody likes him. At that time, I just had a job. I was driving a nice car, Riviera in those days. That was big, of course. It was so dressed pretty well. That's almost instantly, coming out of prison, getting a job, saved all my money. White folks saw it different. They said, this is a potential gang leader. He knows everybody in East Oakland. He doesn't eat pork. He doesn't drink. He has good habits, he saves his money. This guy is a threat. So what did the government do? They took two of my friends. They borrowed $200 from me. They paid me the $200 back. But they paid me back some extra in marijuana. $500 worth in big, big bags. Like if you got three matchboxes, $10 in a bag of marijuana. The bags that I had, they put four matchboxes in there. Fat. And I said, well, what am I doing with this? So guess what? I just sold the marijuana. Now, you got to imagine those days. If you made $100 a week, I sold that marijuana in a week or two. $500. Big fat. So I said, hey man, where you buy this stuff? How it come? And so we'll get these kilos and Negroes weren't really getting kilos, they were getting pounds. But anyway, so I said, man, I'm gonna get me some of this marijuana. And I'm in business. I looked around Oakland, couldn't find any. I called my homeboy in L.A. I said, hey man, y'all got this marijuana? He said, come on down. I went down, bought marijuana, and I used to go down there and buy my marijuana every couple of weeks, whatever. So I became a supplier of marijuana in East Oakland. I mean, an instant supplier, because guess what? People didn't have money. That's what the government wanted me to do. To divert me from becoming a black nationalist, right? I became a marijuana dealer. That's not what happened. I not only became more popular than I ever was, from all the marijuana, I'm the marijuana dealer for all of Oakland, East Oakland. They don't have a regular supplier. You know, where you can go there any time and you can get some smoke. They never had that before. The next thing is, by 1968, I have evolved. I'm big time now. Guess what kicks in? The black nationalism, black enterprise, black entrepreneurship. In the year that Martin Luther King went to Chicago to do the same thing, he failed in Chicago. I was a success in Oakland. Why? It was just like politics. Oakland was just the right size. The same thing with drugs and everything. Just the right size. For businesses, Oakland was the perfect size and the perfect people that was there. Their hopes, dreams, and aspirations was right along with where we was going. So we would fund people. You want to start a business, man? It was all, and it worked. I'm telling you, it kicked in good. So the white man that tried to divert us from our goal and our mission, wasn't our goal then, to try to divert us from our mission, right? By becoming a marijuana dealer, pushed us into it. We become, when they realized what I was doing, that's why I had to go in exile. They said, we're getting rid of this nigga. We're not having none of that. Economic freedom? Economics has a lot to do with freedom. You know, one thing they said in the movie, to make a revolution. Because Simone Bolivar was studying in France and other places. They said the thing you need for a revolution is dinero. That's the first thing you need, money. The second thing you need is dinero, money. So the third thing you need is dinero, money. What is basic? That's why they sanctioned
right.
Iran. Busted out, helping everybody so they cut off its money. With us, we knew what it took all the time. So while we're here, we're playing with the government. That's why every dime we got our hands on, we bought something. And they looked around, we're property owners. D.C., we're 8 pieces of property. We're property owners. Guess what's going up in D.C.? Property. So, every time the European has tried to divert us, he's always helped us. And before our big ascension was always a period of, let's call it downtime. Every time I was into something that was getting a little, I took a little downtime and I watched what's going on, so I would know. It was natural. I didn't read any book on it. This period, we're just coming out of our downtime. And we're studying. We have studied everything we're involved in, any detail. What's going on in the world? Just like black power, black nationalism, and all of that. And black people was on the move. Oakland is that thing again, except this time, Oakland is white people. Oakland is some blacks remain. Gentrification, white people, Latinos. The whole is energized. And now, and Arabs too, in Oakland. The Stormers, Yemenis, it haven't been used right. Now, we going back to Oakland, and we going back on a mission. Hey man, we going back on a mission, it can't fail. So the Oakland story past and present mean everybody got to get ready. So right now in Oakland, as we begin to teach the Oakland story, it's the same as before. People didn't believe that you could become big and powerful in drugs because the white man will finish you off. Well, we showed them what you can do. We showed them exactly what you can do. We showed them how, because they was watching. They was watching us. I'm telling you, when I left Oakland, the main big timers came up out of East Oakland first. Other places came up too, but East Oakland. They looked at me, they knew how to do it. Now, and I gave this lecture 12 years ago in Oakland, this exact same point, that just like Oakland looked at what we did before in Jahiliya, they are now looking at what we did in the Dean. And now, except now, we have studied it better, right? We've chronicled the whole historical process better. We've archived everything that we've been involved in better. We have documented everything better, right? So, whether it's archives, whether it's chronicling, whether it's historicizing, we knew where we wanted to go already. So we've been involved in developing our own roadmap to our own future. That's why we are now capable of writing the book, right, that we want to read, that takes us where we want to go. We have chosen, we are selected where we want to go. And in Oakland, the police department, the governmental agencies have aided and assisted us by opposing us. They're the ones who cleared the way. They cleared the way, they did it. But remember, when it's time for a place to go, all the forces, it's not like the whole cosmos. When it's time for you to go up, the whole cosmos cooperates in your ascension. It's like when America was on the way up, it was as mean as it is today. The things they did in slavery. Did you see that movie about, what was his name, down in the South? He chopped up white folks.
Nat Turner?
Nat Turner. Yeah. Did you see where they had the Negroes starving themselves and that thing, and they busted out their teeth?
Yeah, yeah.
They busted out their teeth and poured food down their mouth. They didn't kill them. They busted out their teeth. They didn't keep them alive. You're going to work here, buddy. You see what I mean? They didn't start killing us till after slavery. Jim Crow, when they didn't own us. The police kill us now because they don't need us to work. But we now are drawing, I mean, in our writing stuff we're doing, a functional picture of the future. The things that are really possible, that's what we're going back to Oakland to educate the people on. Those things that are possible. So, between Washington, D.C. and Oakland, California, this is where we're kicking off. It's not, we're not just getting started. We've been doing this for 40 years in Islamic. So it sounds like we're not just getting started. This is our, you might call it our third state or fourth. We've been through several stages. You know, when we talk about things that happened here, we have a system of knowing what has happened here, Oakland. During our earlier periods, we used to just say, okay, just pull back and look at people here. And then you draw lines connecting those people in Oakland and the cities. It's so simple and ridiculous. And so, all of people that was here, never a surprise. Why we know it is all connected? Because people here that are here right now are connected. Everybody here is connected with everybody out there, except me. Well, how the hell am I able to predict the future then, if I don't have no information coming to me? Don't say it was Press TV. I didn't have no Press TV for a long time. Once the thing, ball gets rolling, you can't stop it. You simply, if we go to California, it's a wonderful trip because we pull ourselves back from, when I go overseas, I look at the whole United States. And I line it all up. And you can actually see it. Once you know how things happen, you could see the people and events unfolding. It's right in front of your face. So, what's possible? Look at it like this. What's possible in the world if we take money and Reba out of affairs? As long as you got money, like capitalism, and you got Reba, you're always going to have the big super rich, because no matter what you do, the people that loan out the money, the banks don't get all the money because they loan it out to people at exorbitant rates, and pretty soon everybody works for the bank. Everybody in the United States owe the bank. They don't own the house, they owe the house, the bank owns the house, right? How many people actually own the house? Then they tell the dummies, after they own the house, get a reverse mortgage. And the people get a damn reverse mortgage. So when they leave that house to their kid, there's $10 left in it, if that, right? Because the reverse mortgage, and I don't know how much they're charging for that thing. That's why we ask, oh Allah, we seek that refuge, anxiety and grief, lack of strength, laziness, cowardice, and niggardliness, in this case, niggardliness is stinginess, from being overpowered by debt and the oppression of men. Tell the truth, if you're in debt, you feel like you're in prison. If you don't have no money, you can't go nowhere. You can't go anywhere. If you don't have any money, your family's going to look at you like, and they're going to ask you, the kids don't know, Daddy, I need a new computer. The other kids have one. Well, we have to wait a little bit. Why? No matter, they can see you working all day long, scratching everywhere. They still don't understand why the hell they don't have what everybody else. They don't understand. I don't mind, don't, but it's no problem. They don't understand why. When they ask me for something, I said, dude, how much it costs? Just go down and get the damn thing. Because it says spend money on your near relatives, right? That's my near relatives. And everything else I spend on the people. I don't need nothing myself. The clothes I got on, I got more clothes than I need. T-shirts, stuff, socks, I don't need anything. Right? That's freedom. Imagine. We're here under heavy oppression. Heavy oppression. Right? But we own our property, and we're oppressed. Other people don't own their property, and they're not even oppressed. They're not, well, they're oppressed, but they ain't under no, they're not under the 24/7 of the United States government. Everything we're doing with the United States government parked in the front line. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Right? Using maximum oochie-goochie or whatever you got, and guess what? for us. The system we have domesticated, I've used those words before. We have trained the system. The system works for us. It don't make no difference what they think. They work for us. We have domesticated the white man. Nobody else did. You know why nobody else did? Because they never even thought about it. Just like the people of Bovine who was buying and helping. They never thought about nothing higher than their butthole. They now got freedom. Grand Columbia, what the hell is that? Right? That great idea is too far out there. Do you know? One of the things that we have is we have to break this thing down so the Negro will understand what the heck we're talking about. So far, he's not getting it. So far, somebody's not getting it. So far, somebody is cutting it out. That's why I would have to take all these DVDs and everything and duplicate them and have a mass handout. Why? Because some kind of way that white man is messing with that. Because I don't get no telephone calls. With all this stuff, I don't know. No, sir. The white man is doing something. You know how stuff come to me stupidly? I'll show you this. Somebody put these papers down. The one from April 19th. Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints invites Islamic delegation to Utah. Who's in there? That's the imam from over there. And this is Bahraini out at the IEC. You see that turban on his head? And you're in. Somebody dropped this off here so I could see this. I could see the imam over, and probably they would want me to think, why do they go all the way over to Utah and they don't come visit you at the masjid? Why are you so tied with the Iranians, but Bahraini is going out there, over there, right? I just really looked at this the other day. They've been down there since Ramadan, so I just actually looked at this the other day. I didn't pay no attention. And that's good. You know why? Because the message I'm supposed to get is so old.